Hey, what's up? This is Joe Sly with Casa Real Estate, and in this video, we're gonna talk about the home buying process, and we're gonna go through each of the steps so that you can feel comfortable and confident when buying your first home or your next home. Step number one is to get pre-approved. This is important because you wanna have clear expectation as to how much you can afford, and then also it'll give you more time to really understand all the financing and all the details, and you can ask questions so that there are no surprises when buying your house. Step number two is to hire a professional real estate agent. One way to go about this is by asking your friends and family who have recently purchased a home and ask them if they can recommend that realtor to you. Also, it's good to check for that realtor's reviews and see if that realtor is a good fit for you. Lastly, you should feel comfortable to ask the realtor questions, maybe do a little interview and just kind of get to see how they do business and how they can help you find the right home. Once you have hired a realtor, then the next step would be to meet with them so that you can tell them what your goals are, what you're looking for, and then that realtor will help you formulate a plan and a strategy so you can find your next home. Step three is to start looking at homes. This is probably one of the most fun steps because you get to see houses, right? While looking at homes, you'll be able to figure out and kind of zoom in more into what it is that you're looking for and what's really important to you and what isn't. So this is a fun step, but also a very important one. Step number four is making an offer. This is a very important step, and it's one where you're gonna rely a lot on your real estate agent. They're gonna help you with the negotiating and finalizing all the details. Once you are under contract, then the next step, or step number five, would be to have a professional home inspection. Your real estate agent will give you some options as to who you can hire for an inspector, and you can feel free to check out their reviews, or if you know someone else who's purchased a home that had a great inspector, feel free to ask them for a recommendation. Once you have done and completed the inspection and you have negotiated with the seller if there are things that need to be fixed, then once all that is settled, then you'll move on to step number six. Step number six is to finalize your mortgage application. During this step, you will meet with the lender, you will lock in your interest rate, and they'll give you a closing disclosure with all the information and all the numbers. Some of these numbers might change a little bit, but for the most part, they should be pretty set. Your lender will also order an appraisal, and they will also get the title work started. Step number seven is to start looking for a home insurance. Make sure that you get a couple quotes from different companies so that you can compare them, and make sure that you're also comparing apples to apples. So in this step, you'll rely a lot on the insurance agents that you're working with. Step eight is to plan your move. During this step, you'll do a couple things. You'll start packing, you'll start hiring your movers if you're gonna hire movers. You can start contacting utility companies. Usually you can do the utility companies about a week or so before the day that you close and move to your house. Step number nine is to do a walkthrough. During this step, you will go with your real estate agent to the property, usually about a day or so before the day of closing, or sometimes even during the same day that you close. You will go to the house and you just want to make sure that everything looks good. If the seller was going to have a contractor fix things, make sure that those things are fixed. And if they were supposed to have any invoices or anything in writing that the things that were supposed to be fixed were fixed, make sure you get that as well. And this is just kind of a fun day for you to look at the property again and just make sure that everything looks good. Step number 10 is the closing date. And this is the most exciting day because this is the day that you're finally, after all the hard work you've put into it, you're getting the keys to your new home. And this day you'll go with your real estate agent to the closing. Usually the lender will be there as well, and you'll sign a lot of papers, but at the end you'll get your keys, and then the title will be transferred from the seller to you, the new homeowner. Now I would like to go through each of the steps again quickly and just give you an estimate on how long it will take for you to accomplish each of these steps. So if we're starting today, day one, with the pre-approval process, that's step one, that will usually take you about 1 to 3 days, right, to get that finalized. Step two, hiring a professional real estate agent, will take you anywhere from day two to day four, so that's about 2 days. Step three, once you start looking at homes, that could be anywhere from, you know, a week to several weeks. But let's say it'll take you 2 weeks to find a house, and that'll be from day four to day 18. Now, step four is making an offer. And once you've found the right home, Let's say that's on day 18, and between day 18 and day 19, that's 2 days, then that's when you'll have everything finalized with your offer. The step 5, which is inspection, that'll take you about 3 days. So let's say from day 19 to day 22, that's when the inspection is taking place, you're negotiating and all that gets finalized. Steps 6 through 9 will take you several days to weeks. So let's say that once you finish the inspection on day 22, you meet with the lender on the day after, so on day 23, you finalize your mortgage application, then you'll start looking for an insurance. You'll also start planning your move, contacting the utility companies, and then step 9 would be the walkthrough. So from step 6 to 9, that'll be about, let's say, 27 days. So you'll be at day 49 once you've accomplished all that. And then the walkthrough will be on day 50. And then after the walkthrough, right, you'll have the closing date, which will be step number 10, and that'll be on day 51. So the whole home buying process can take you 51 days from when you start with the pre-approval to your closing. You can do it a lot sooner if you have to, and you can also take longer if you need to or if you haven't found the right house. If you have any questions after watching this video, please feel free to write it on the comments below. I'm happy to help and looking forward to answering any questions that you may have.